Welcome back to the channel. Today is going to be a little bit different from my usual types of contents. I was able to pick up that guy behind me. That is a Synology RS2416RP Plus, I believe. It's a pretty loud NAS server. So it was in a data center environment for about 5 years, which is longer than expected because it ran into that Intel CPU bug where one day it just turns itself off or you reboot it and it won't come back. So it's dead, it's out of warranty, it's out of extended warranty. So I figured I would go ahead and there's an unofficial fix out there that involves soldering a 100 ohm resistor onto the motherboard at some very specific places. And I'm going to attempt that one today and see if it comes back. It'd be kind of neat if it does. Certainly couldn't trust it in production anymore, but I'm going to jump into that and see what happens. For your reference, when it does this, the primary signs and symptoms are, one, it never becomes accessible over the network, but two, you see the power light and a blinking amber light, and what I kind of call the watermelon. You'll see three greens and a bunch of red. So there's our blinking amber. There's the green and red. This thing will not boot, it's done. To crack into this guy, it's just this one screw here at the very end of the case. You can see the motherboard here, pretty basic. I'll get you in here in a minute. Let's get in here and look at the motherboard real quick. So here inside the case, we see that the actual motherboard is pretty compact here. We just have the three SAS connectors. I think that's just the standard 24-pin ATX power, and then a couple of other little incidental cables. But of course, the Intel Atom CPU is under here. It has failed. Now, the fix from a wonderful guy on the internet who I'll link that thread in the comments. Maybe a few threads, there's a lot of discussion on this topic. But basically the gist is the internet says if you put a 100 ohm resistor or quarter or half watt, I'll put that specific part in the description as well, and it can make this thing come back to life even though it is basically dead at this point. Now, the thing we're most interested in is actually over here, and I'll show you that in a moment. Now again, specifically, this is for an RS2416RP+. The motherboard looks pretty similar to a few other models I've seen referenced on the internet. But it's this little bit right here. It's a little 12-pin unused socket at this point. And everything I read says that you put a resistor on pin 1 and pin 6. And this can come back. So if it's just that simple, let's see what we can do. It does appear that the screws that hold the serial port here and the expansion port also need to be removed to actually remove the motherboard, so we'll do that now as well. Okay, I went the unnecessarily lazy route of just taking all the screws off this panel here, and then magically the whole thing came loose. And I see now it's because it has these raised standoffs. The trick was to lift it up. Duh. So here on the back side, we see our pre-installed 2 gigs of RAM. And there's, of course, the slot on the back. I think you can do a maximum of 4 gigs in these. You have to use the specifically supported Synology ones for these. I don't know how well that's gonna show up on camera, but this board is kind of filthy. There's all kinds of cloudiness left over from the manufacturing process. Meh. But let's get to the actual repair here, which, as I mentioned, is here on this corner, pins 1 and 6. So we'll just be soldering the resistor right there. Right, so forgive my workspace, it's a little bit limited here. I'd love to have a grounding pad down and everything, but I digress. This just needs to go from pin 1 to pin 6. Really should be as simple as that. I can make it look ugly, but I'll make it pretty. All right, with that in place, let's solder it in. All right, that isn't pretty, but it should be solid enough. Guys, I'm gonna be honest, I have not soldered anything on a circuit board in a while. So that ain't pretty, but I sure hope it's functional. All right, that's installed, and that looks just about like every picture you can find online. Let's see if that has any effect. All right, again, taking that metal back piece off, totally unnecessary. You just take off the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws and then lift it up and out and it comes out. And I made it way harder than it has to be as usual. But with that, we should be able to power it up and see if it does anything. All right, we either get life or magic smoke. Okay, flashing blue, no amber, no drives yet, but we'll see. All right, I had just given up on it. I guess that was it doing the DSM update, and it's actually come back, fully. All right, after all that, let's see if that effort was worth it. We will launch the Synology Assistant program. And there it is. This thing used to be named NAS4. Let's see if we can connect to it. And there's the login screen. This is what I didn't get to see after upgrading from 6.4 to 7. So this is the first time I get to see the new sign-in screen. We'll put in the username. And wow, yeah, this is about right where we left it. It was out of production, fortunately, when it died. We had already moved all of the backups off of it and reinitialized the arrays. And it was during that reinitialization of all of the arrays we found out that we had some bad sectors going on. And there's 2 of the 3 it was complaining about. I think disk 6 had bad sectors, but they're not. That's funny, it healed itself. Don't you just love it when hardware does that, just fixes itself? But yeah, 11 and 6, or 11 and 3, still failing. Well, that's it for this one. I get to remove all of the hard drives and return them to the office spare parts pile. Yeah, you never know when a 6-terabyte hard drive might come in handy. And I get to start collecting all of my little spare hard drives around the house and maybe put them in this thing. But thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.